Welcome back, students. So I hope you are, all of you are comfortable with the matrix and the, after that the next chapter called as determinants. So in my last class we started the topic called as determinants. So a quick revision. I'll just see what we have learned in the last topic. What is a determinant? How to expand? That's it. Nothing else. Okay. So that's how, that's all we have learned. So what is a determinant? First thing. So determinant. Okay. So as I said, if I have a function f from a to b, where a is set of all square matrices and b is set of all real numbers, then a real number which is associated with a square matrix is called as the determinant of that square matrix. So for example, if I consider a matrix A given by 2, 3, minus 2, 1. This is the matrix, 2 cross 2 matrix, square matrix. So the determinant of this is denoted by like this. Two vertical lines inside that A should be written. Okay, right. Then it should be 2, 3, minus 2, 1. So how to expand it? Quite simple. You can expand it from any row or from any column. The standard way of expanding and convenient way, we'll always expand it from the first row until unless it's not necessary. Okay. So first we'll multiply the left diagonal minus the right diagonal. Okay. So left diagonal, if I multiply these two, 2 multiplied by 1 will be 2. Minus sign because here. Okay. And 3 multiplied by minus 2 will be minus 6. So on simplifying, I'm going to get 8. Then this 8 is called as the determinant of this square matrix. Okay. So a real number which is associated with every square matrix is called the determinant of that square matrix. That's all. Okay. So a simple definition. So I told you how to expand even a determinant of order 3. Okay. And the value remains same. You expand it from any row or from any column. This concept also I have explained you. Okay, so we expand it from first row, first column, second row, second column, from anywhere, the value still remains to be same. Okay, this is all we have learned, that's it, nothing else. Okay, and after doing the full exercise, I told you just solve one problem and I will tell you the importance of this problem, okay, in the next class. So the problem was something like this. I have given a square matrix 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89. This was the square matrix I said, right? Then I said, you find out what will be the determinant of this square matrix, correct? I told you, use your calculator, do whatever you want and get the answer finally. And actually, the final answer is 0. But you got this after doing lot of calculation. Simply nobody would have got so easily. Okay, you would have expanded from first row, then multiply. See, 85 number multiplied by 89 will take a lot of time to just normal multiplication, quick multiplication, correct? Otherwise use calculator. See, whatever you do, you have done some lot of calculation to get this answer 0, right? But it is not at all difficult. I can do this problem without using calculator or without doing lot of calculation. Okay, simply I can get the answer. Getting the answer is so easy for such kind of problem. And to get that zero and to get that answer using a simple calculation, or to get the answer without using calculator, now I should study something called as properties of determinants, the most important concept under this chapter. Okay, so we have something called as properties of determinant. After doing all the property, I will come back to the same problem and I will tell you fraction of second you will get the answer. Maybe you got this answer, maybe something, maybe 2 or 3 minutes you would have taken. I will solve the same problem in a matter of seconds. Hardly 20, 30 seconds you will get the answer for such kind of problem. But to reach that, I need to learn something called as properties of determinant first. Then I will come back to this problem and I will show you how the answer will be zero without using calculator, without doing lot of calculation, how to get the answer in seconds. So remember, okay. Okay, now let us start today's class. Properties of determinants. Okay. See, in your book actually there are only 6 properties. I have included 2 more. So totally how many properties? It's going to be 8 properties. So we're going to study all the 8 properties with proof. It is printed in EPL. You can go through that, please refer and copy down. Okay. So It does not see if it's there in EPL, it does not mean that you should not copy the same thing actually. Please note down, okay, the thing should not be in EPL. The thing should be in your classwork. Okay, so please make sure you'll make a note of all the properties. You will write down all the properties, just like what I'm going to explain. Properties are there, proof is there. The only thing is I should explain to you. That's it. So among them, one of the property, the first property, the statement is given there actually. See, the value of the determinant remains same if the rows and columns are interchanged. That is the statement. I'm not going to write the statements here. So statements are there. I'm just going to explain to you. Clear, students? So how to just prove this one? Quite simple. Let's consider a determinant delta. I'm going to call it determinant delta. So let me take A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Clear? So I've taken this determinant in standard. See, properties should not be explained with examples, should not be proved with example. It should be proved in general. If in an examination also, don't give examples, just prove it. Clear? So what they say is, so this is delta. I will take one more, delta 1. What I will do here, whatever is there in row wise, I will write it in column wise. So this will be my A1, A2, A3, and this will be B1, B2, B3, and this will be C1, C2, C3. So what I have done from here to here, delta 1 is a determinant obtained by interchanging the rows and columns of delta. Everything is there in your EPL. You have to just note down the thing. That's it. Remember. Fine. So let us expand both of them and let us see what will be the answer. I'm going to expand this with respect to first row. So what is the first element? The first element is A1 multiplied by. You can directly practice this. Product of left minus the right. Correct now? So it's going to be B2 C3 minus B3 C2. Correct? The next element is A2. Open the bracket. So you have to multiply these two and multiply it by these two. So B1 C3 minus B3 C1. For the last element, plus A3 multiplied by. So it's an element of C3 and R1. Leave that. The remainings are these four. So it's going to be B1 C2 minus B2 C1. This is my equation number one. That's the expansion of delta. Now I want to expand this delta one. So I can expand it from any row, any column. What I will do here, I will expand it from first column. I will expand it from first column. So the first column sign, plus minus plus. You should remember the sign matrix always. So the first element is A1, leaving the row and column, the remaining four elements, B2, C3, minus B3, C2. Now the next element is minus A2. It's an element of R2 and C1. Leaving that, the remaining four elements, so it's going to be B1, C3, minus B3, C1. Now the last one is A3. A3 multiplied by, it's an element of R3 and C1. Leaving that, expand these two, B1, C2, minus B2, C1. Let me take this as equation number two. Notice these two, both are same. So what is this says? This says delta is equal to delta 1. Meaning, if in a determinant, if you're interchanging all the rows and columns of a given determinant and expanding, the value still remains to be same. So that is the proof for the first property. Statement is there, so you can make a note of the statement. Then how to expand it, how to prove it, that's the way. So take a determinant delta in the standard form, expand it and keep it as equation 1. Interchange all the rows and columns, fine. And then you are going to expand it. See, I already told you, you can expand it from any row or from any column. So for our convenience, okay, let us expand it from first column so that I can match with my equation 1. That's all. Fine. Okay. That is property number 1. Now, just notice, I'm going to do something now. This is delta 1. This is delta. What I will do here, I will interchange my first row and second row. So, first row and second row will be interchanged. That's the symbol, double arrow. Okay, arrows on both sides, suggesting that those two rows are interchanged. Okay, so let me just take down B1, B2, B3, A1, A2, A3, and C1, C2, C3. So I have taken a determinant standard form, right? I've expanded, I got my equation. This is my property number two explanation, which is going on now. We'll come to the statement later on. Okay. Now what I've done here, delta 1 is a determinant obtained from delta by interchanging R1 and R2. Now, for our convenience, let us expand it from R2 Okay, I'm going to expand it from R2 means second row. Okay, the signs have written on the top of it. My first element is minus A1. It's an element of R2 and C1. Leaving that, the remaining elements will be expanded B2, C3, minus B3, C2. My next element is A2 and that too plus A2. Fine. So it's an element of C2 and R2. The remaining elements are these four. So let us multiply B1, C3, minus B3, C1. My last element is minus A3. Right. That's an element of R2 and C3. Leaving that, the remainings are these four. So let me expand B1, C2, minus B2, C1. I have expanded from second row, so I have mentioned here. Even in the proof also I have mentioned. So let me take minus sign outside from all the three. This is my first term, this is second term, this is third term. So minus plus minus from all the three I will take minus outside. The remaining elements are A1 multiplied by B2 C3 minus B3 C2. This will become minus A2 B1 C3 minus B3 C1, and this last element is going to be plus A3 multiplied by B1 C2 minus B2 C1. Clear, students? Just to observe the things which is inside the bracket, students. This is nothing but the expansion of delta. So the right side, what is there, can be written as minus delta. Now let me explain you the concept. See, what is the difference between the first theorem and the second theorem? In first property, all the rows and columns were interchanged. But in the second property, any two rows or two columns will be interchanged. So what I did, I interchanged R1, R2. Okay, remember, it will be for any two rows or two columns, but the explanation is given for interchanging two rows. You can go for two columns also, still the answer remains to be same. So what happens is, if in a determinant, if all the rows and columns are interchanged, the value remains same. But if you are interchanging only two rows or two columns, the value changes by a sign. For example, suppose think that on expansion of this, I am going to get the value as 100. Then you will interchange R1, R2, you will expand, the final value is going to be minus 100. Or this is minus 100, this is going to be plus 100. So the conclusion is, if in a determinant, if you are interchanging any two rows or two columns, the value changes by a sign. That's a property we have to remember. So the difference between first and second, first, all the rows and columns are interchanged, the value remains to be same. Second, if any two rows, two columns are interchanged, the value changes by a sign. Clear, students? Fine. Now I am going to go for property number 3. Property number 3, I am going to expand it, okay? So to start with property number 3, let me consider A1, A2, A3. Second row is also A1, A2, A3. So what do you observe? First row, second row are identical, or we say same elements. In the first row and second elements having same elements, or we say standardly first row is identical with the second row. Let us expand this. So I can expand it from anywhere. So as usual, I am going to go for my first row only. So let me expand it. So this is A1 multiplied by, let me expand these two, A2 C3 minus A3 C2. My next element minus A2 multiply these. So A1 C3 minus A3 C1. Students, now I don't think you're feeling it difficult because I'm expanding directly, because yesterday purely the class went on how to expand a determinant. And I said I'm going to stop it right now, because once you're ready with the expansions, then future you will feel everything is easy. So that's why I did two properties yesterday in yesterday's class. Okay, so your job was to go and understand and come back and sit in the next class so that you can understand the expansions quite easily. If you know the expansion, nothing will be a problem here. So let me expand it to the third element, plus A3 multiplied by, so let me expand it, A1 C2 minus A2 C1. I've expanded. What I will do here, I will remove the brackets. That means I will multiply everything. So multiply A1 for these two, A1, A2, C3, minus, if I multiply this, A1, C2, A3. So you maintain the order 1, 2, 3. It will be easy for us to cancel in the later on stages. So A1, C2, A3. So I maintain the order 1, 2, 3 here. Let us multiply here, minus A1, A2, C3 minus multiplied by minus will be plus C1 A2 A3. Let us expand the last thing. A1 C2 A3 minus C1 A2 A3. So remove all the brackets by multiplying. So A1 A2 C3 minus A1 A2 C3 get cancels. Next, minus A1 C2 A3 plus A1 C2 A3 get cancels. The remaining is C1 A2 A3 and C1 A2 A3 also get cancels. What's the answer? 0. So what is the statement? If in a determinant any two rows or two columns, remember every statement, almost every statement starts with rows or columns, okay, but most of the explanation will be given in terms of rows only. Let's come back to the statement. If in a determinant, if the elements of any two rows or two columns are identical, then the value of the determinant will be 0. That means if you see a determinant where two rows or two columns are same or identical, you don't go and expand and check the thing till the last step. No, directly you can say the value is 0. This will be very helpful. Okay, this will be helpful even if I solve the problem of 81, 82, 83 later on. Remember, okay. So this is my property number 3 statement. So that's over. Now let's go to the next. Okay, so fourth one, property number 4. So in standard I will take a determinant. Okay, so I'm going to expand it. This is what the expansion is going to be. So we got the expansion of delta. What I do here, I will construct a determinant delta 1. See, you have to mention what is delta 1 actually. In the proof also I have mentioned. Delta 1 is a determinant obtained by multiplying any row or any column by a scalar called k. So just observe what I do. K A1, K A2, K A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So what is delta 1? Delta 1 is a determinant obtained by multiplying the elements of first row by a scalar called k. Got it? Okay. Now I will explain the, see, first thing, most of the times I will explain the concept, I will explain the proof, then I will come back to the statement. That will be easy for us. Okay, so let us expand this also. So what I do here, I will expand it from first row. So my first element k a1 multiplied by b2 c3 minus b3 c2 minus k a2 multiplied by b1 c3 minus b3 c1 plus the last element k a3 multiplied by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. I have expanded from first row. So notice here there is something called as k common from all the three terms. There are three terms, first term, second term, third term, and in all the three k is common. Let me take that outside. What is the remaining? A1 multiplied by b2 c3 minus b3 c2 minus a2 b1 c3 minus b3 c1 plus a3 multiplied by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Clear? And the one which is inside the bracket, that is nothing but the expansion of delta. So the right side can be written as k multiplied by delta and the left side is delta 1. Let's come to the conclusion. So what is the meaning of this fourth property is all about. So what they say is, if in a determinant, if you multiply the elements of any row or any column by a scalar, the value of the whole determinant is multiplied by the scalar. You won't understand the meaning. So what I will do here, let me think that I have taken delta. This is the determinant given to me. So after expansion, let me think that the value is 10. To this determinant, let me multiply a scalar called, first row elements is multiplied by a scalar called as 2, right? What is the final answer will be? The final answer delta 1 will be equal to 2 times 10, that's going to be 20. If in a determinant, the elements of any row or any column is multiplied by a scalar, then the value of the new determinant is scalar multiplied by the determinant. That is the statement. So you have the statement, I told you the meaning. Okay, don't worry, when you will get examples based on this, you will understand better. So this is how the proofs are going to be. Yes, certainly sometimes, not every time, Sometimes they will ask you one of these properties in the main examination. Okay, students. So this is my fourth property. Now the board is little bigger, so it will be easy for me to just go and explain you all these properties. If the board was small like earlier, things would have been different. Okay, now let's go to the fifth one. So what is the fifth one says? Better to go with the proof directly. So let us reconsider elements I wanted, right? Standard form. So a1 plus alpha, a2 plus beta, a3 plus gamma. Then this is as usual b1, b2, b3, and this is c1, c2, c3. What you notice in the first row, each element is sum of 2. Correct, no? Each element is made up of sum of 2. Right. Let's see what this can be expressed as. As usual, I'm going to expand it with respect to first row. So on expanding, so a1 plus alpha, right, a1 plus this is lambda I've taken, right? So it's better if I take alpha, beta, gamma, right? Okay, fine. Now this is multiplied by b2 c3 minus b3 c2 minus a2 plus beta multiplied by, so you know how to block this and how to multiply these two. So b1 c3 minus b3 c1 and the last term plus a3 plus gamma multiplied by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. That's fine. Okay, now I'm going to expand this. Actually, I'm not going to open this bracket, but I'm going to open this bracket by multiplying. So what I mean to say is, first multiply by a1 for this one. So a1 plus b2 c3 minus b3 c2. My next term is plus alpha times this, right? See what I do here, I will explain you how to multiply and how to arrange at the same time. See, totally there will be 6 terms. So what you do is, first 3 terms you arrange it in the first row, and the next 3 terms you arrange it in the second row. Okay, anyway, otherwise one more extra step you have to do, that's it. Okay, plus alpha times, alpha will be multiplied for this. So alpha multiplied by b2 c3 minus b3 c2 minus, now multiply here, a2 multiplied by b1 c3 minus b3 c1. Now multiply minus beta for this. So I told you just below this, b1 c3 minus b3 c1. Now multiply a3. a3 multiplied by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Next, plus gamma multiplied by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. Students, remember, all this 6 is in one step, that's it. Okay, this is not okay, it doesn't mean that this is after this, then this is the next step. No, I multiply and then they arrange at the same time, but actually it's just one step together, right? So I've taken a determinant delta where first row is made up of sum of 2 elements. Clear? So I expanded. After expansion, I'm trying to open these brackets, right, and multiply and arrange at the same time. This is what I have done. Now what I do next is, observe carefully, students. The first 3 terms, what is there, is nothing but a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. See, the previous 3 explanation have given the what is the expansion of delta. There you can go and check. So the first 3 terms, what is there, is nothing but the determinant a1, a2, a3, b1, b2, b3, c1, c2, c3. What is the change from the first row to the second row? The only change is, in place of a1, a2, a3, I have alpha, beta, gamma. So that means my next 3, but before that, before the next, the sign should be plus. Plus and the next 3, correct, no? The only change between the first 3 and the next 3, a1, a2, a3 is replaced by alpha, beta, gamma, but these two remains same, c1, c2, c3. So what is the conclusion then? If in a determinant, the elements of any row or any column is made up of sum of 2, it can be expressed as sum of 2 determinants of the same order. That means you can split this and expand it into 2 different determinants and add it. That is the meaning. This you can do for any row or from any column, not just for the first row. So that's another property. So let's see the next one.